Welcome to the Daily Business and Finance Show. In this episode, we delve into the fluctuating world of lithium prices and Janus's predictions. We shine a spotlight on the JP Morgan event, exploring biotech M&A, obesity trends, and AI advancements. We roll with Nvidia, Microsoft, and others at CES as Vegas embraces AI. Get ready for an earnings week ahead featuring Citigroup, JP Morgan, United Health, and Delta Airlines. It's time for JP Morgan updates from the medtech industry. And finally, we wrap up with a weekly roundup of the materials sector featuring Alpha Metallurgical at its peak and Gold Fields at its low point. Stay tuned after our short ad break to learn more about these exciting developments. Forecasts suggest a decline in lithium prices until 2025, driven by an upsurge in supply and a decrease in demand from China and the U.S. electric vehicle market. This information comes directly from the Australian government. A potential outcome of this could be a reduction in the cost of electric vehicles, however, it may also negatively affect investment within this sector. Despite these predictions, Janus Henderson Investors remains optimistic about a possible recovery in lithium prices and expects an increase in deals related to lithium mining.
The JP Morgan Healthcare Conference, taking place in San Francisco, is anticipated to draw a crowd of over 80,000 participants. The event's primary focus will be on biotech transactions, weight loss medications, and the role of artificial intelligence in healthcare. In the previous year, there was a significant increase in pharma and biotech deals, with their value rising by 38% and 45% respectively. Weight loss medications developed by Novo Nordisk and Eli Lilly are gaining popularity. Additionally, antibody drug conjugates used for cancer treatment have been making news due to major acquisitions. Artificial intelligence is another crucial topic this year, with an expected rise in budget allocation.
The Consumer Electronics Show, also known as CES, is anticipated to be heavily influenced by advancements in artificial intelligence, or AI, this year. This prediction comes from Dan Ives, an analyst at Wedbush Securities. It's expected that major technology corporations such as Nvidia, Microsoft, Intel, and Dell will unveil their most recent AI developments. The automotive industry is also set to have a significant presence at the event, with a particular emphasis on the integration of AI in vehicles. Key themes are predicted to include generative AI applications like data analysis and content creation.
The week ahead marks the commencement of the earnings season, with prominent corporations including Tilray, JP Morgan, Bank of America, BlackRock, Citigroup, Delta Airlines, and United Health poised to disclose their quarterly results. Commercial Metals is forecasting a robust Q1 performance in spite of hurdles encountered in Europe and North America. In other news, Tilray, a Canadian cannabis firm, has experienced a 40% surge in share value over the past 6 months. On another note, KB Home, a home building company, is projected to report an annual decrease in both earnings per share and revenue. Lastly, Infosys, an IT services provider, will also be unveiling its Q3 earnings.
The yearly JP Morgan Healthcare Conference is set to feature numerous medical technology companies, such as 10 Times Genomics, Exact Sciences, and Guardant Health, among others. They will be providing updates on their progress. Canaccord Genuity is forecasting preliminary financial results for the fourth quarter of 2023 from Akoya Biosciences and Exact Sciences, among other firms. However, they do not foresee any guidance for 2024 or information regarding the recent departure of Illumina's chief operating officer. On another note, Needham estimates that at least 13 companies will pre-announce their fourth quarter earnings by mid-January. Shares from Alphatech and Hologic are projected to outperform.
This week witnessed a 1.63% drop in the S&P 500 materials sector. Gold futures also saw their first weekly decline in a month, triggered by a stronger U.S. dollar and increased treasury yields. Silver didn't fare well either, with a decrease of 3%, while copper reached its lowest point in 2 weeks due to worries about China's dwindling manufacturing activity. On the brighter side, Alpha Metallurgical Resources and Arch Resources emerged as top gainers among basic material stocks. However, Gold Fields and Hecla Mining found themselves on the losing end.
And that wraps up today's episode of the Daily Business and Finance Show. Stay savvy, stay informed, and we'll catch you on the next wave of business news. Farewell. I'm Montgomery Jones.
And I'm Amalia Dupre. It's been a pleasure, until we meet again tomorrow.
This content is sourced from the Seeking Alpha website, so support our podcast by becoming a Seeking Alpha Premium subscriber. See the show notes page for links to sign up. This episode is produced by Classic Studios. This podcast provides information only and should not be construed as financial or business advice. Check out our other podcasts in our network at classicstudios.com.